at a pizzeria in Pennsylvania. An employee records a customer who is demanding a refund.
You're out of business.
But her issue seems to have less to do with the food, and according to a witness, more to do with the language she is hearing throughout the restaurant.
You want to have Spanish on your TV?
What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with that? Because you're not American, dude. I will look you the up and get you the out of our town, okay? Give me my money back.
At the register is Omar Quinones, who has owned the restaurant for a decade and has never experienced anything like this.
We never had a problem with the customers before. Sometimes we put music, it's in different languages, Spanish or Italian music, and I never had a problem with nobody. I was not expecting that, cancel the order just because that TV that was in Spanish.
I'm not giving my money to some illegal immigrant. Well then, you got Spanish on your TV. That's you to Americans, dude. My father was a World War II veteran, okay? His friends and family died. So you can sit here right now and make money. And you're gonna do this kind of.
Omar is willing to honor her refund request, but her offensive rant continues.
Give me a crowd. I want your food. I want a credit for my money right now.
And her vitriol isn't limited to Omar.
And she's videotaping me. Yeah,
because you're racist.
You're a victim.
You're racist.
You're a victim.
I'm not a victim.
You're a victim. No, I'm an American.
No, you're racist. A
after a bit more back and forth with the staff, the customer switches tactics.
I'm gonna film you right now, and I got 4,000 followers.
This is our first Karen. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
And tries to put the restaurant on blast.
I am being videotaped because I am white and they want to call me racist. I am simply asking for a refund because their food is terrible.
You said that you want a refund because you played Spanish on a TV.
I want a refund on my credit card and they are calling me racist because I am white.
The customer shows no signs of backing down.
I'm waiting. I got my card right here.
All right, leave here now.
Right here.
Until finally, an officer arrives.
What's going on, man?
According to Omar, the officer brings the customer outside of the restaurant and provides her with the cash refund. But she is later arrested and charged with ethnic intimidation and harassment.
It's frustrating that that's the way that she was acting, that you think that how many more people that are like that.
Hey, I've been in there for 55 years. Guess what? You're out of business.
But there is a bright spot to this very ugly encounter. Word about the incident spreads and business booms as a show of support for Omar, his family, and their pizzeria.
I will look you up and get you out of our town.
We have a lot of support from the customers and a lot of phone calls showing the support and everything, saying that not everybody is like her. So that was really nice, and that makes the difference.
Give me my money back.
A customer's request for a refund is turning ugly.
Get your pants and go.
I want my shirt.
I told you, you ain't getting.
According to the person filming, this woman just tried to exchange a pair of pants and buy a new shirt. But when informed that there was still a small amount owed after the pants exchange, the back and forth about it grew heated and went on for several minutes. Now, the worker's patience has worn thin and she's refusing to do any further business with the customer.
Well, that's fine. I just want my shirt.
And you're not getting
it. You're not.
upstairs. Well, here.
The intervening coworker manages to stay calm.
You get my shirt.
But moments later, finds herself drawn in to the altercation.
I want my money back. I'm not doing anything.
You have to give me my money back.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I don't.
I'm returning it.
I can refuse sale to anyone.
Where's the sign?
Where's your sign?
Get out of my
Where's your sign?
That's okay. I'll send this to corporate. I've been recording the whole time. I'll send this to corporate.
Every time I come
she
in,
will lose her job.
Eat anyway.
Girl.
Having made it personal, the customer decides to leave, but not before calling the woman one of the most vulgar curse words possible. Store employees and some passersby managed to keep the employee from leaving the store.
She dropped her phone with purple hair. I didn't want nobody to step on it.
While the customer heads home to presumably contact the store's head office.
Good luck in fire, dumb bitch!
No word on any fallout from the altercation.
Somebody.
Get out! Get out! No! Get out!
After reportedly waiting too long for her order, this enraged customer just barged into a restaurant that is only doing takeout.
No!
And now several employees are pushing her back out.
Get out!
Get out!
Get this bitch off me! No! Get out! Stop it! Get her off me! I am yummy, I'm getting my refund!
You need to unlock the door.
I want my money refunded!
You will get your money back.
Where?
Not
the
way. Not to the way.
The manager agrees to the refund, but before they can even process the request. The employee who was struck grabs a fistful of the customer's hair.
Hey, let go of her hair!
Several other employees try to stop it from escalating any further.
Stop! That is enough!
And the parties are finally separated.
I was assaulted and I had the whole crowd to see
you stand in front of her!
She's been shoving up on me the whole time!
The irate customer, who leaves the scene before police arrive, is later tracked down and charged with a misdemeanor count of defiant trespass and summary counts of disorderly conduct and harassment. Not to mention, potentially making other customers wait even longer for their takeout orders.
We got people are waiting for 3 hours for food.
In Torrance, California.
I love you, asshole. Now you can't take it to the higher level. I said, let's stop.
A loud back and forth between a customer and an employee is gaining steam.
You know, it ain't $2.
How much you want your money back?
Jack, shut your ass up. Just give it back.
According to the person filming, the customer is upset because he claims he paid $2 more than the listed price for the merchandise that he just bought. But even as the cashier is attempting to refund him the $2.
How do you want your money back?
Give it cash.
Okay, cash.
The animosity continues.
I hope you have a great night, Apple.
You too, mother.
I hope you have a
you
great
too, mother.
And not just with the cashier.
You better watch your ass.
You better watch your ass.
You this got nothing to do with
hey, Donald.
You got nothing
to do
with
anybody.
I ain't gonna watch your ass.
Now, multiple employees and customers are taking issue with the man's behavior.
Why are you coming up to me? Now I got three people. Oh, I said, what did I say?
You're gonna
fight a kid? Over what, $2? Grow the f up.
the employee in the light blue shirt, gives the man his money, hoping to bring the situation to an end.
Have a good night. Have a good night. Hey!
But the customer seems determined to have the last word.
Yo, you already caused enough service.
See? Go.
Go.
Yeah, you'll see me again.
You can see me anytime.
Oh, yeah. We'll see.
And with that ominous warning, the customer finally exits without even taking the items he paid for.
Have a great night.
Leaving the employee in the light blue shirt to offer the customers who witnessed the ugliness an apology.
I'm sorry, everybody.
So remember, if it seems like you're making a big deal over a $2 price difference, you probably are. One thing a customer can't return is a haircut they don't like. But that doesn't mean they have to accept it.
I'm here at the salon asking for a refund because I got a terrible haircut.
Your language
and this is a customer.
The man filming was so displeased with the cut he got from the salon that he went home, shaved his head, and is now back to get a refund.
I'm a customer and you have offended me.
I'm not talking to you.
Get off of me.
I'm not on you.
Stop hitting me.
I'm hitting you.
Get out of here.
But the salon's current customer claims to be offended by his language and brings the situation to a whole other level.
Get out of this!
Look at this!
You get out of this!
My arms are hooked, dude! Hey, if she doesn't get her, she's grabbing me, dude!
No!
No! I'm not talking to you! I'm not talking to you! This whole thing is being recorded! Alright, I'm calling the cops. Look at this lady! This whole thing's being recorded, you psychopath! Go sit the down, you nutcase!
The altercation quickly devolves into claims of physical abuse.
My rib.
Your rib? Good, your rib. You slammed into me. My hands
your
are up in
language.
There.
Which?
I haven't said one bad word.
That F word you've been screaming since you walked in?
Hey, all I said is I want a refund if you're not gonna give me... There, thank you. You are insane.
He finally gets his refund and tries to leave, but the irate woman seems hell-bent on making him pay for his language.
Let's get out here and have it out.
Yeah.
Go!
Look! You just kicked me. Dude. Hey.
Get out of here!
You wanna kick me again?
Get out!
Alright, hey, I'm calling the cops and they're coming down here.
Get out!
Get the hell out of here, okay?
Dude, your wife is assaulting me. Your wife is assaulting me.
You're a maniac. What's wrong with you?
I'm not a maniac. I came in here to get a refund.
You are a maniac.
And you are kicking me. What the hell is wrong with you? This is insane.
According to the man who got the displeasing haircut, none of the employees of the salon try to intervene when the customer, who it turns out is the owner's mother-in-law, went after him.
I'm a customer and you have offended me.
I'm not talking to you.
Get off of me.
I'm not on you.
Stop hitting me.
I'm hitting you.
Get out of here.
But after hearing what happened, the owner of the salon offers him free haircuts for a year. Not surprisingly, he declines.
Get out of
you want to kick
face.
Me again?
No charges are filed.
Get out.
In Charlotte, North Carolina, the man at this drive-thru window has a problem with his order.
I need my money back and I want it fast.
A big problem.
Double hamburger. Is there cheese in hamburger? There's no cheese in hamburger. When you have a cheeseburger, you have a cheeseburger. If you have hamburger, you have hamburger.
But the presence of cheese is not the only problem with his order.
There's not even bacon on this, and not onion on this, and not anything that I asked for. This is such incompetence, I cannot believe it. It happens every time I come here. I want my money back.
But the enraged customer's biggest beef?
I'm losing my because this happened the past three times I've come. Please be competent. Once in your life. Once. Take an order and fill it.
And to top it off, when he finally receives his refund,
I paid more than this. I want $10. You sons of bitches.
Someone please give this poor man a hamburger.
The double hamburger.
That's hamburger. Hold the cheese.
There's no cheese in hamburger.